I tried some vacuum seal bags from the dollar store, and the seal lasted for about an hour. So now I'm buying some more expensive bags and trying these out. So after putting my winter bedspread from my twin bed into the big bag, I'm sealing the top using this plastic tool that is provided in the box. Next, I need to loosen this gray knob to allow the vacuum to suck out the air. On the inside of the knob, you'll see the air intake, and you don't want that right up against your bedspread or contents. This way it won't block the airflow. You'll know that everything's going well when you apply the vacuum and the air starts coming out rather quickly. I'm just taking care to arrange this while the air is coming out so that it's a decent shape. I did try this the first time and I found I couldn't get it into my cabinet because once it's all compressed, it's actually quite heavy and not bendable. So I'm doing this to get it as a more compact shape, a more even shape. I'm tightening the gray knob there just before I turn off the vacuum. That will allow me not to lose any air out of there. And I'm tightening it just a little bit more to be on the safe side, just in case I didn't tighten it enough the first time. It's a little awkward to tighten these things. You may have heard that thump on that last one. It is really quite heavy when it's compacted like that. This one I'm redoing. Again, the shape was not that great when I first did it. So I'll undo the knob here. And I actually undid it too much. I took it right out. You don't need to do that. And then that little piece just fell. So I gotta remember to put those back. I was gonna open this part and then I realized it's actually doing a good job of decompressing just through that little hole. So I'm just gonna shake this down. This is a duvet from a twin and a robe, a winter robe, terry cloth robe. Okay, so I have to put this little knob back on here that I unscrewed too much. So screw that back in. And I'm going to do a before and after this time. Okay, I just found the little thing that dropped off that I didn't notice before, so I have to unscrew my little thing, put this little... kind of like a plastic washer. Don't really know what it's there for, but it came that way, so I'll put it back. Okay, so now I should be ready. I've taken apart many things and put them back together again and had pieces left over, so I don't want to do that this time. Now, can you spot my error? Although you can't see it, the vacuum is against that little knob, but the bag isn't shrinking. So then I realized I have tightened this knob too much. So I'm going to unscrew it a little bit. This time I'm going to try not to unscrew it all the way like I did last time when the whole thing fell out. So two hands on this one. Okay, you can see that this definitely worked. It works really fast, so if it doesn't compress quickly, there's a problem. Okay, again, I'm forming this so that it'll be a decent shape so that I can get it into the cabinet okay. Okay, so I'm tightening it before I take the vacuum off. The vacuum does a good job of just staying stuck here. It's just being held by the suction power. And I'm tightening it just a little bit more after I took the vacuum off, just in case I didn't get it the first time sealed enough. My cheaper bags, they did look good, like this, but then after a couple hours, I noticed they were starting to expand and I couldn't tell where the leak was coming from. So that's why I invested in these more expensive ones. I bought these from Jisk. Let's just compare what this one looks like to the one that I had done before. This one's a bit more evenly shaped. See, that's how I started out the first time I did it. That time I just vacuumed it and I didn't care how it turned out. And let's see how I've improved on my measurements. 16. Okay, so a little bit smaller now that I took more care in packing it. Fits into my cabinet just fine. So as you can see from my before and after dimensions, it actually didn't save me that much space. You can also see that I don't get the nice uniform compressed look that the front of the box indicated. By the way, when you're packing contents in the bag, the contents have to start out below this dotted line. Keep that in mind when you're selecting bag size. Overall, this is a decent product, but quite honestly, I think I'd prefer to store most of my stuff without these plastic bags. It's a lot easier to just stuff them into that cabinet than it is to fiddle around with these bags, getting them the right shape. I also didn't like how it was quite heavy and not bendable, the final product. However, I have learned from about my 30 minutes worth of experience, so my future takes would probably be better. But overall, I think I'll do what my mother and grandmother and women before did, which is just store them in a cabinet unless I'm really concerned about bugs.